to another episode of Naija to America. This is our third roundtable discussion, and we have some more guests with us. We're going to be talking about moving back home to Nigeria or not, which I think is a very interesting topic. We're doing this in honor of Nigeria's Independence Day, which is on October 1st. So yay, in Nigeria. So keep watching. This is going to be fun, engaging, and as always, let us know what you think in the comments. So I'm going to start with the introduction. As you guys all know, my name is Yuandi, and then starting with.
Hi everyone, I'm Wumi. I'm a medical doctor in residency, specifically family medicine.
Hey guys, I'm Nosun Kuba. I work in project controls in the construction engineering field.
Hi guys, my name is Amy. I am an accountant, specifically technical accounting.
Hi guys, my name is Moyo. I'm a videographer, specifically Nigerian American videographer.
But yeah, as always, I'm Moyo.
All right, let's get started. So first question, how long have you guys been away from Nigeria? We can start with you, Wumi.
Okay, so I've lived away for about 8 years now, and I've just been hopping about England, Grenada, and the US.
I've lived away from Nigeria, and I've lived in the US for a total of 8 years now.
Same here, lived in the US the entire time, and I've been away for 9 years. I've been living in the US for 9 years.
You've been away from Nigeria.
Been away from Nigeria for 9 years,
yeah. For me, I've been in the US and the entire period 6 years now.
And I've been in the US the least longest. I've been here for 4 years. Why did you all choose to come to the US and not any other country? And for me, yours is specifically different because you've lived two other countries. So why did you end up here?
So for me, it was more of me just pursuing my dream. So wherever I had to go, that's where I went to. So my medical school was in Grenada, and then it was really aligned with the US. So I came here for part of it for about 3 years to do clinical rotations.
So mine was like, because I've been, as a kid, I come here more and more, so I was more familiar with the area. I had family across the state, so it was just easier to choose here as opposed to any other country.
And for me, it's because I had more family members here too, compared to like other countries. So, yeah, no choice.
I mean, America is nice, right? What do you think?
So before I came, I was actually scared, nervous, because you know, America is big. In England, you know everybody. You go up on the train, you see this person, you see that person, but it's turned out well for sure. I'm enjoying it.
Good. All right. So when you came to the US, did you guys have plans to move back home? I can tell myself. Well, I had like an idea that I would like to go back home. It just didn't have a timeline. So I wouldn't say I had a plan to move back home. It was just like, oh, when I'm done with school at some point, I'd like to go back home. I don't think I really thought about this. I mean, we all went to the embassy to say what we're going back home.
Not all of us. We got the call to go come to the embassy for your visa and all, right? The guy was like, okay, this and that. I was so nervous. So I was like, what would you like to do after you finish school? I was like, okay, I have this answer. I balanced. I was like, you know what? Maybe I'll try to get a job with maybe Boeing or rather. My guy can just change. Next thing, you just brought a stamp. You're like, nah, you're not supposed to stay in the US. I was like, okay, don't worry. Noted for next time.
If you're watching this, don't ever go to the embassy to say you plan to stay after. They know that people stay, there's OPT, there's HMB, they know that people stay, but don't go there, guys, that's like the center
shop.
Going for school, and that's it. So you guys, did you plan to go back home when you were coming here? You plan to go back home?
I did. I wanted to move back home, like, right after college. That's what I told them. And that's what I actually had at the back of my mind.
So,
but
when I got here, then started going through college, I was like, oh, okay, maybe I can, you know, walk here for like a year.
It's kind of nice.
I was like, it's kind of nice, but I don't have enough experience if I do 1 year, right? So let me just do 2 years.
Like, you know, maybe 5 years.
Maybe 10 Maybe 20 years.
Maybe after my kid has to go to
school. My kid goes to school.
Yeah, life is
great. Life, yeah.
How about you, Omi? For me, I always wanted to go back, to be honest. You know, because my dad always says, you know, if everybody went to it, who will help your people? Say, okay, don't worry. I'll be very patriotic. I'll come back. But now, it's gonna be hard.
Why is he going to be watching this? You know, say, you're not coming back.
No, I don't know. I should watch it, definitely.
Yeah. I think I had that conversation.
No, we haven't had the conversation.
Oh, is this letting you write after this?
I don't know. No, but honestly, no, one step at a time. One step at a time, but we'll see.
Okay.
So I guess your answer is you might not move back.
I might not.
She had a plan. So
I
know about the plans now.
Okay.
She had a plan. You know, there was a country.
Oh, no, sure.
Yeah. All right. So next question. Would you ever move back home? Why not? What are your reasons for choosing to move back home or for staying?
Well,
hey guys, like, so you
guys let's see what I'm thinking. Me, when I first came in, I'm like, I'm going back home. I love Nigeria so much, you know. But now, I don't know. But if I was going to move back home, it would be number one to be close to family because my parents are there. And then just, you know, that sense of I want to give back. I feel like that's a very noble thing to do, but in reality, I don't know if that's the right thing to do. But it would be just give
the
back.
The right thing or the best thing.
The best thing, my bad. Out of my
choice of words.
Yeah, I don't know if that's the best thing to do, at least right now. Because you hear all these things about Nigeria, and I mean, I don't know if I imagine that Nigeria is hard right now, and just like the state of the economy, and you just have to have a plan when you're trying to go back, when you want to move back home. But for now, I don't know. I feel like ultimately, I'll still want to go back just to be. I want to raise my kids in Nigeria. I want them to have that what I had growing up. I want them to at least be a part of that.
You want them to have the also.
Yeah, let's see who you are. Wow, we all know you. But then it's a matter of time, I guess, and like, everything will figure themselves out. But for now, we are here. I'm enjoying the journey.
Okay, so your reasons for moving back home is
family, wanting to give back, and then wanting to raise my family back home.
Okay.
Yeah.
How about you, Owen?
So my reasons are similar to you and me as well. Like, definitely, I don't mind moving back home, but then it's just gonna be hard in terms of how I've been trained here. So, like,
you say trained, like,
let's focus on the
career.
Positive. Why do you want to go back
home? Why do I want to go back home? Well, for family, most of my family is still back home there. Like, my entire family is still there. Cousins, everyone, to stay close to family. That would be good. Being able to give back, educate, help out, for sure. Those would be my reasons.
Okay.
I would have loved to say family, but honestly, some of my family members there are planning to come over here. So. But yeah,
casting.
I think... I think the goal in my head has always been you come over here, you get the education, you get the resources, you get all the experience you want, and then you eventually go back there. Because, let's be honest, it's easier to live back there and to make money there. It's easier to... It depends, honestly. If you're coming with...
Let's focus on the positive.
It's easier to make money there.
I feel like it depends on what you're doing, though.
As a doctor, you don't think it's easy to make...
Yes! Unless
you're
like,
all those
videos. Why is she on doctors make money in Nigeria. Are you kidding me?
No, okay. I feel like if you're like in the top 1%,
not everybody.
But
are you coming to be at the bottom?
But like, why did you have to be a
doctor? Housemanship.
I mean, why do you think
that
you
have to be at the bottom?
There's more coming.
I shall do a lot of
things. Yes, but NYC. Have you done NYC?
Oh, yeah, no. Just wait until after 30 and then you go.
Get messed up, done NYC every Monday. Just so you know.
Just so you know. struggle.
So if any of you apply to go back home, you should go to
I feel like for professional things, like I don't know if it's like easier to make money back there. I feel like for professional.
It's not I'm not saying go there and start working for someone else. Why would you do that? Business is hard everywhere, but once you get your
money,
it's easier to set up business in Nigeria, to be honest.
There
are barriers, yes, but if you have resources which you're going to get from here and go back, it's easier for you to move.
Okay, it's moving back to make the dough, but yeah.
Also, I would like my kids to be raised in the Nigerian culture. So, let's just leave it at that for now.
For me, it's mostly what they've said, like raising family, I think is the most important one for me, raising family back in Nigeria, having that Nigerian culture, and then going through the also that I went through. How would I tell my children that I walked from this place to that, I'm just joking, I walked from this street to this street.
And I still came first.
No, but like there's a different kind of like also spirits in Nigeria. In the average Nigerian, to be honest, like, and that's why we're able to come here and like do really well, I think. That's my own like opinion. But in terms of like, I think you
resist
for
all of that.
Yeah, that's
not what it is. in terms of
family and stuff, like, our family half and half.
Yeah.
And we can always come here, I can always go there. Mm-hmm. Yeah. But that's it.
I think for me, it's pretty much the same. Raising kids. Being around family and your Nigerian culture. There's something about being Nigeria. It's beautiful weddings.
Oh, I love
it. It's nice. Life is so different. So just that, having that Nigerian life.
All right, guys. So that was a very interesting conversation. We're going to end it there. So just like, comment, and subscribe, and stay tuned for the next video.
Wait,
I don't say Benway, so.
What does that mean?
Carry your mouth.
Carry your mouth.
Like, shut up.
Benway, so.